Now, prefabs have been around in other game engines for a while. GameMaker prefabs are just getting started, so there's not a lot there, and there's nothing outside from the community at the time of this recording. However, they are still shaping up to be really interesting and definitely something to check out, with a few caveats depending on when you're watching this. So, as an idea, a prefab is a prefabricated collection of assets. So you're thinking sprites, objects, sequences, anything inside of GameMaker, prefabricated, made by somebody else, that you can then use inside of your projects. And what's nice about it is it's not just downloading something. It's actually using and pulling the most recent prefab of the one you're using all the time. So let's say you are using some sprites, right? You're using this tree and someone updates that prefab. Automatically within your project, it's going to be used and pulled inside of there to always have the latest version. Now, you can actually come in here and you can actually choose a different version. So if you wanted one or two or whatever, you could use specific ones. If you want to stay up to date, you don't have to do anything except use it the way they intend. And you can also take anything and completely make it your own by putting... To use a prefab in general, you're actually going to have to go up to Windows and open the prefab library. And then it shows up right down here and you'll want to pull up to have some space, okay? Opening up the package manager shows you what we've got so far. So right now, pretty much, I think everything is actually from GameMaker. And this is pretty much all of their asset bundles that they've created over time, which is fantastic. This is such an easier way to access them. If you've ever tried to use their marketplace or download them or import projects, it was a hassle. So this is so much simpler. So let's say you're making a sci-fi space shooter and you want to use some of their assets. Well, all we have to do is click on it, click install, it updates right here, and then it's going to tell you it's done. And if there were any dependencies, other projects or assets you needed to make this prefab work, it automatically downloads them, which is really handy as well. So now if we come down here, I've got my sci-fi space shooter right here. Currently, they're pretty much only sprites and sounds. So I can come into the sprites and I can check them out. There they are. Before, we had to actually manually import all of these that we want, but now they're actually here. But what's really nice is they are not in this project itself yet. You can see I have a few over here and I'll show you how to do that, but they are not actually in my project right now. They actually live just in GameMaker and they don't get added until you actually manually add the ones you want and then build it. So it is always pulling the most recent and it's not cluttering up your asset browser. It's not cluttering up your game. Now, on the flip side, it is a little bit of work to get them into your project, right? So I can't just take this sprite that I love and toss it over here. It doesn't work. It won't allow you to do that. If you're in a room, you can, if you're in an asset, right, asset layer, you can just drag that in there, no problem. That works just fine. But you can't edit these or do anything to them the way they are right now. The other way you can do it is if you have an object, you can come into the object, and let me bring this over here. What are you doing? So, if I bring this over here to the sprite, I have this as my sprite now. Now, I think prefabs are still pretty early on, so the enemy itself doesn't change the sprite over here on the right, which is a little obnoxious, but it's not the end of the world, okay? This enemy does indeed have that sprite, so go to my instances layer, drag it in, you can see it works. So just from the asset browser, it doesn't update, but it works perfectly over here. Now, let's say you actually wanted to use something and edit it, right? Let's say we really like this, but I want to change something. Maybe it's animated and I need to change it, or I need to alter the origin or add a flare, you know, whatever the case. What you're going to do is you're going to right click on this. So every prefab has some information about it. Once you've used a prefab from a project, you can actually edit it inside of code, which I'll show you in a second, or you can duplicate it into your project. And over here, we actually have the file, so io.gamemaker.scifishooter version 1. That's what this is. Now, this is in this project as a local file. What that means is if this project, this prefab, gets updated in the future, this sprite will not change. It is in my project locally. So I can come in here and I can do some awful alterations to it and add my own pretty colors and, you know, whatever. I should never do that. Don't ever let me draw, okay? But if you do that, this is now my sprite that I can use anywhere. You can rename it, you can do anything you want because it's a sprite in your own project. Perfect, okay? Exactly how you would expect it to work. If I don't do that, what I can do is in my object, okay? Because I have a reference to this prefab, this sci-fi space shooter, I have a reference to it, which means that I'm using something from it somewhere. So this enemy ship, you can actually see this icon appeared. It shows me that this object, this right here, is being used somewhere in my project. That is called a reference. Once you have a reference, you can actually reference it through code. You can reference everything inside of this prefab through code. So if I say SPR enemy ship, that is now a sprite that I can actually access. So all of these things are now accessible through code anywhere I want. So I could come in here and change this to, let's see, is there, that's enemy, here's a player, let's go over here. Player ship heavy, okay? So SPR player ship heavy. So I'm going to run that and put this back in the room without making 1,000 more of these. And you can see that although the sprite I set was one thing, I can actually access the code from another. And what's really nice is usually this is going to show up, so I'm guessing this is either a code editor bug or it's still just a prefab that they're working on because this is still pretty early. But all of these can now be referenced. And again, you can reference the versions, which right now is all version 1, but you'll be able to reference individual versions inside of here eventually. And if you come in here, you can actually look and it tells you, hey, you can access specific package versions and specific assets that you want and all of that information. So it's super flexible, really nice, okay? You can also come in, right? You've got sound effects. So if we click on something like here, we can actually listen to it. So then we can, again, just right click, import or duplicate into projects, and that now becomes our sound effect that we can use anywhere, and it's actually local to our game. But again, if we didn't do that, then anytime these gets updated, the prefab gets updated, our project pulls from the latest, which is really handy, okay? So all of that is super fantastic. I love this idea of prefabs and the way this works, okay? This simplifies so much of what GameMaker has been throwing out the last couple years, which has been fantastic stuff. Like all of these, I'm trying to grab something here, because then of course it doesn't show up, right? All of this stuff that they've added over the years, all of the free things that they've put up have been amazing. Like all of these are fantastic sprites and assets and sound effects and tile sets, but they've been difficult to work with. So Prefab fixes that. And moving forward, when they open it up to the community, I can see prefabs being incredible for demo projects or specific versions of characters and objects that you want to use and share in a fantastic way. So here's the downside though. Right now, it is definitely still just getting started. So you have to be careful with this. Okay, they have things for UI panels, like the UI icons and panels and user interface. And what's really nice is they have some actual like functional objects over here. So if I open this up, we can actually look at something like a text box. And it shows you it has events and it has a ton of variable definitions. So you can actually throw a text box in here. And if I run this, it is a fully functional object. I can come in here and I can type in it. That's what this text box does. It allows you to type, move focus, and all of that. It's pretty cool. All of these in the prefab library are workable, usable objects that just do things. They're prefabricated, they're made for you, and so you can just use them however you want. It's pretty nice. So, here's the catch though. Right now, there are a few bugs to be concerned about. If you'll notice, my game is Prefabs 3. And that's because when you use some of these, it has a few dependencies. So if I go over here to the package manager, see if I can replicate this, okay? I would recommend staying away from user interface right now. It is 0.1.3 for a very good reason. It will essentially break your project. So if I uninstall this, nope, won't allow you to uninstall for using it. So when you install this for the first time, it installs a couple of dependencies, but those dependencies seem extremely unreliable right now. So all the other projects I've tested this with, essentially when you start trying to use this, if I bring this into my project, which is fantastic code, everything is really well commented and it works fantastic. So this is the code for the text box right here. Fantastic stuff. But now if I load this, after using this project a couple times, if I close and exit out of it, right? I'll show you, go to prefabs 2, you just get this error and you just can't do anything. It just can't find the path to something that this is one of the folders it was supposed to add for my text box. It just crashes. You cannot open up this project anymore. Now there's probably a workaround, but as of right now, it is really frustrating to add in a prefab like a text box and then have it completely brick your project. You can't even open it to fix it. It's just resource load failure. So I imagine, oh, there it is. Prefab 3 is now unloadable. So I imagine that's something that they're going to fix, but until they do, don't use any of anything under 1.0. It will probably completely brick your project. The other problem I had was when you're doing prefabs, all right, let's go to prefabs 4. There's the errors. Boom, boom. You come down to the prefabs, and if I want to use something like a sound, like a vehicle, air, jet. Let's grab this jet right here, right? I want to use this jet in my project. I want to duplicate it in. The first time you open up a new project, maybe it's brand new projects, I'm not entirely sure, but if you open up a new project and you try to duplicate something in, it does not work. So I continue clicking on duplicate. There is nothing here. So I'm going to come back over here. I'm going to exit out. I'm going to open up GameMaker again. And now when I go back in, for every time I click duplicate, I'm going to have that asset inside of my GameMaker project. It seems to only be a very first project or a very first time using a prefab there. So here it is twice, and now I can use it and override it and do exactly what I want with it, no problem. And from here, then I can go in and I can grab, let's say, a sound. And then I can right-click, duplicate into project, and it works perfectly fine. No problems there, right? So a few bugs and glitches here and there, a definite game-breaking one when it comes to user interface. I would highly recommend not using anything under 1.0 right now. This user interface looks like it's going to be super cool, but I would keep it uninstalled and recommend not using it at the moment. But overall, prefabs look to be something fantastic. My only primary concern is going to be if they put this into a monetary, like they monetize this, right? So right now, all of their stuff is free. And right now, the only things on here are things from GameMaker. You have prefabs, but you also have tools. So you can localize into other languages. You have some specific GM tools like for Linux and ARM. And you have the GameMaker runtime that you can install and do things. So the prefab system is not just assets. It's also tools and very useful things to make GameMaker better. Now, if they turn prefabs into a way to sell your assets, that could be fine, right? People who work on things deserve to make money. I sell some things. And I think that's okay as long as there is a good balance. I think GameMaker has one of the best communities out there. And I know that as soon as this is available, I'll be throwing some of my projects into the prefab to be shared. So I think it could be a really good balance as long as you still have high quality projects and a way to be able to both monetize and find free stuff and have it be genuinely useful. So overall, this I am super excited about. I think prefabs are going to be a game maker game changer. I think they've been around in other game engines for quite a while, but the way GameMaker's doing them through this with auto updating when you use them, all of that stuff, I think is going to be fantastic. And if I can prefab my own projects and assets, like, that's going to be amazing for working on projects. I'm super stoked. So let me know what you thought. Let me know what you're excited for, what you're worried about, if you've been using it, and how it compares to other engines that maybe you've used, or what features you're still thinking you'd love to see. Thanks for joining me. That's all I've got for you today. Keep making, keep learning, and I'll talk to you later.